So I'm back in DevTools, and one of the things you can do is hit Escape on your keyboard. And it brings up this extra menu here with Console, Search, Emulation, and Rendering. We're interested in the rendering options. What I'm going to do is switch on Show Composited Layer Borders. When it's switched on, the page will show you a grid. These light blue lines represent the tiles that each layer is split into. But as developers, there's nothing we can do about that. It's just how the browser chose to split up a layer. But the interesting ones are these orange boxes here, which you can see around the circles. These orange boxes are elements that are on their own compositor layer. So how then do we make one of these layers? Seems like it might be pretty useful. Well, there are ways that virtually every browser uses, and some are hackier than others. Let's start with the newer, not hacky way. In Chrome and Firefox, you can use the willChange CSS property to tell the browser to expect visual changes. It can then choose to put the element on a new compositor layer. In this case, we have willChangeTransform, and that tells the browser that we intend to change the element's transform at some point. And so to prepare for that, it creates a new layer. Instead of transform, you could also put left, top, width, or height, or any visual property. But even if the browser's expecting those changes, it would still have to run layout and paint for them. So the forewarning that you plan to change them won't actually yield much improvement. The benefit of willChangeTransform comes because creating new layers can be expensive, because they need to be created and then painted. And doing that on the fly can be expensive. For older browsers and Safari, you'll need to use something like a 3D transform. In fact, a transform of translate Z0 is the most common form of this hack. It's called the null transform hack by most people. And it applies a 3D transform, pushing the element in Z space by absolutely nothing. It's enough, though, to persuade the browser to create a layer. In a production environment, you'll probably need both transform translate Z0 and willChangeTransform. You shouldn't use hacks unnecessarily, but today, not all browsers support willChange, so you may well need to. The null transform hack forces the browser's hand, but willChange is a hint that the browser can ignore, and that gives the browser more options. It's better to let the browser decide what to do where you can. With willChange, you're giving it the hint, but letting it decide what to do with it.